Asleep, I am awakened by the ghost of Christmas future, whose cloaked figure steps beside my bed and grants me a vision of Christmases to come. Outside, rain turns to snow, and my soul is transported to the hilltop locale of my father's grave. He is not dead yet, but soon. Where snow bites my cheek, as my spirit hovers above, here lies and refuses to read the rest. My head creaks towards the ghost, and I beg him in horror to stop. But the blizzard only worsens until nothing exists but me and the tombstone. Time seems to slow in the forest winter. Hours turn into seconds, as the wind carries me back to an ancient sonnet. There my father, chest full of life, walks me up a forest trail and picks the most difficult path to follow, then heaves heavy breaths as he inches up a hill. We have lunch at the top, and my father tells me that he is glad to have this opportunity because soon it may not exist. Later that day we bathe in the river, warm water washing this boat, and I am pulled back to by the ghost the lonely world of the future. My spirit hovers again above the grave, and the river lingers in my mind. My frozen eyes refuse it access, and my reddened face remains dry. Behind me, the cold wind howls, and the ghost of Christmas stands still as his cloak tatters away. Here lies your fate, his winter voice booms. Unless you put this tale behind you, you shall never escape me. I look at him pleadingly and only shake my head, and for a moment I can feel his disappointment. Then I am whisked back to my bed, where his form is no more, but his presence remains. And deep into the night I lay sleepless, curled and staring at the wall, motionless as I beg to be rid of the specter from the hell.